Hello, everybody. This is Matthew and Daz, and this is 217 Top Trades. Let's get it. So today is December 13th, 2023. And I know it's been a while for everybody, but I just want to come on here and let everybody know that today we have hit all-time highs for the Dow 30. And this is what everybody on Wall Street has pretty much just been doing the last, you know, probably about a whole year now. After the whole campaign of what the Fed's doing, but let me just play it for you guys. They've just been buying funds day in and day out. The first rate hike, they have bought it, and they have bought it clean up. So let me just go up just a little bit more and let this beat drop, because it's going to hit hard. And they've been just buying everything up. And I'll get into a little bit of chart action with you guys, because I know everyone wants to see that stuff. A little technical analysis and all that. And then another one I like to do. Is everybody in the market is just pumping it up. I mean, we're in a new bull market. Moo, yo, 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 moo. Bull market, baby. And then that's just a little pump it up for you guys. And then I like this one, you know, because everybody seems to be like...
There's been something on my mind that I've been dying to share.
Sorry, freaking YouTube. Here we go. You guys probably know it's... In the market, everybody's getting up, you know? So, in the club, I just like that a little bit because, you know, it kind of just, it smacks, you know? I mean, all this money going in and out, like, they just keep partying it up. And the regular old Joe, you know, blue-collar person will never catch up. That is what I'm here for. The blue-collar Joe needs to just keep on adding in just like they do, and it'll all be good, you know, in the end. So, to all the white-collar jobs, you know, congrats, you know. I'll go to a list. I'm just going to flip it around here and kind of talk about everything else I got to talk about now. So, let me go. All right, here we go. See ya, 50. But now it's my turn to talk. So, here's all the Dow companies. We got American Express, Amgen, Apple, Boeing, Caterpillar, Cisco Systems, Chevron, Goldman Sachs, Home Depot, Honeywell, IBM, Intel Corp. We got Johnson & Johnson, Coca-Cola, JP Morgan, McDonald's, 3M, Merck, Microsoft, Nike, Procter & Gamble, Travelers Companies, United Health Group, Salesforce, Verizon, Visa, Walgreens, Walmart, Walt Disney, and Dow. Now, I know all these are not necessarily on their highs, but as a whole, in a collective whole, they are at all-time highs. Right here, Fed rates hold steady, indicates three cuts coming in 2024. That is true. That's exactly why the markets actually ripped today. They did. I got a little stuff here. I'm not going to necessarily show it to you guys, but I got a little things I wrote here. So I guess you guys can just, well, fuck it. You guys can look at it. But anyways, the stock market today, big dog Dow, they went 37,000 points, the most high all time. The U.S. 30, they did 536 points after about 1 o'clock today when Jay Powell was speaking and went to a dovish note saying that they're going to pause right now. So, and they have been pausing for the last couple of months, but yes, they went to all-time highs, 1.47% to 37,114. The U.S. 500 went up 65 points or a 1.41% up to 4,709. All-time high is about 1% away or so. Maybe a little, probably about 3% away, actually. up to 4,817, and NASDAQ rose 206 points today at 16,560 points. So it's actually about, I'd say about 200 points away from its all-time highs at 16,776. That's about where it's at. But anyways, I got here a couple little things. I'm not going to show it to you. You guys can look at my pretty little computer here. Anyways, the S&P 500 fear gauge barometer or fear market gauge is actually lower than COVID. So actually that means it's at 12.05. It actually means a lot of people are not buying shorts right now. They're not shorting this market because they just know a lot of people are buying into it. So shorts have actually completely almost disappeared from the market. In retrospect speaking, what actually did go up was in COVID, it went up all the way to 80. The barometer, it actually went up to 80 when COVID was happening, meaning a lot of people were buying shorts and people were selling off their huge shares. But anyways, Jay Powell, rate hikes, he said we're going to stop, but in 2024, we are going to cut a few times. So the FOMC raising rates campaign, they are trying, or they did, hopefully, and this is like going to be a soft landing, what they say is to hold control of inflation, and they are actually doing it pretty darn well. So that is really good, and they're going to keep it at 5.5. The federal funds rate there. And actually a whole nother thing is oil went down to negative 40 during COVID, and they're like, well, who would have thought? That in my opinion is a trade of the century. It ran all the way up to $130 per barrel in 2022, and has actually been slowing down the past, you know, about year and a half, and it's down to 69.5 for WTI. But anyways, I'm going to show you some charts on what everything matters. COVID happened and all that stuff. It'll actually help you understand what we're looking at here. I'm not going to try to be on here for too terribly long. But anyways, the inflation ran up to 9.1 in mid-2022. And that's when we started raising rates really aggressively. And that's actually has been coming down now to 3.1, and the Fed's FOMC, Jay Powell and company, they actually want to get it down to 2%. But anyways, I'm going to go to my other thing where you guys can actually watch. So here is the Dow Jones, and this is just today. So I got a couple lines here. I'll show you what they mean and what they are. So like this is just in the morning, kind of just chopping around, just kind of doing nothing, waiting. And then like right on the dot, 2 o'clock Eastern time, 1 o'clock Central time, just boom, major buys into the market. And then just pretty much running away, because that's when they said, you know, we're not going to raise rates and this and that, blah, 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 Jay Powell speaking. And then it kind of just ran up. Come back down and run up, and just like I said, that's what you call a pump up in the market. And this is a one-day chart, and I got here, the black line is a moving average, and the red line is my VWAP volume weighted average price, and then the yellow is a 200-day moving average. So then I always like to always go to, you know, my five-day chart. This is Yahoo Finance, if you guys cannot tell. Really, really great, great source that you guys could watch or anybody could use and put, you know, indicators on. But this is what I use day in and day out. But like I always like to use a 5-day chart, you know, kind of just see where it's all going. It looks like VWAP just handsomely going up and up and up. But then I kind of do 1 month charts. I like to do 3 month charts, you know, see like down under here, and then like down here is the RSI. It looks like right now, as we speak, we are 84. Anything at 20 is actually you guys can't probably see it there, but anything under 20, this is another RSI, relative strength indicator, meaning we are underbought down here below 20 and 84. Anything over 80 is actually, overbought. So right now, technically, I mean, look at the divergence here. Like over the moving average, we're pretty high, and over the 200-day moving average. And actually, this is called right here a golden cross when the moving average goes above the 200-day moving average. So that means like right here, this is just a pretty good buy for the market here. But anyways, don't want to keep talking on about this stuff necessarily. I'm going to get to the S&P 500 and NASDAQ pretty much to show you the same stuff. But anyways, this is six months, year to date. Looks like pretty good buy right down here. 31 we were at, and now we're up at 84. And you can tell, you know, this is from, looks like Halloween, 10:30. We've just pretty much been on a roller coaster, nonstop, pump it up, you know, from the bottom there. And I always like to use the one year, maybe 2 year, but 5 years always a good one. Cause look at this chart right over here to the left. That is a, that's COVID drop right there. And then just steadily up right there. That's our last top in 2022. And then that's when we started with the rates raising right here. And they always say buy the first rate. I didn't understand why, but now I do. Cause right about here was one of their first rates. Oops. One of their first rates. And look at that. Now, if you bought there, you're going to be rewarded with green. They always say sell panic. So they're selling, selling, selling. But you got to buy hope. And this is the hope. You know, we went down. This is a five-year chart also. Is very key when a moving average goes below. We kind of touched the 200-day moving average down here a little bit, but then just rocketed right up above the moving average for the Dow. But now I'm on to the S&P 500, it looks like here. So pretty much same stuff. Let me go to the day chart. It looks like a lot of money came in at, you know, right at close. So it's looking pretty good for tomorrow. But anytime you see the VWAP just pretty much hitting a straight 45, that means you got to know it's going up. I mean, it's just chasing. So, but like I said, it just bounces right when Powell speaks. Money just started coming in and flowing. And that's pretty much it. And then pretty much just go for the 1 year. Pretty much if you overlay these, they're pretty much going to be the exact same, same charts, you could say. The Dow 500, the Dow 30 is actually outpacing both of these. They have not reached their all-time highs. Excuse me. I have not talked for a while. But anyways, it's 1 year. Yeah, 5 year. It's almost right there at the all-time highs, you can see, but pretty much just been cruising on up. And lastly, we got the NASDAQ 100. Excuse me, I'm getting all these mixed up, but like I said, pretty much didn't do anything all day. And then boom, just right at 1-2 o'clock on the East Coast, just start buying it up, you know, all day and every day, pump it up. But anyways, I like to always use the, you know, these charts, 5 day, 1 month, 3 month is always good to see like where we're going. And it looks like 76. So we're starting to get overbought really here at these prices. But I always like to say, I like to see divergence. So divergence for the Dow 30 going up above all-time highs, that's really astonishing to me. So that means we're in a new bull market, which is amazing for all the bulls and long-term holders. So congratulations to everybody that's holding longs here. And I would just say future outlook. I would say, you know, economy is looking great. We're looking at another soft landing, which is just astonishing to me after going through all this stuff where with COVID and this. I mean, we're just absolutely on a roll right now. The only thing I do see in the future is geopolitical tensions with China and Russia and anything else you could think of. But I could say, not confidently, but you know, pretty decent. We could be going up for the next couple of years. The only thing is they say history repeats itself. So we got to watch out for the year 29. There might be a big crash. And I kind of believe in the New World Order, I guess. They want to control everything by 2030. So kind of just we got to watch out for that. But that's, hey, that's down the road. And I'm sure a lot more will happen from now until then. We got 6 to 7 years for that. So, but you never know how long this bull market could go with the AIs and all that new jazz and everything going on in the world. You just got to be on your toes, but coming a long way from, you know, 2 years seems like a long time, but coming from these all time highs to now, you know, coming back to them is just, it's very good. The best. There's a quote, I think Warren Buffett said, he goes, it is better to be, it's harder to time the market than to be in the market. Like, I can't remember exactly how it goes. Time in the market is better than timing the market is how it goes, actually. I just thought of it. But yes, I mean, you know, just got to be watching all this stuff play out. And it's just really cool to see. If you guys need any more technical analysis on any type of stock, anything, I would be glad to go about it. But I really specialize in futures, you know, and all that stuff. So anyways, this is my long-winded talk, you know, 17 minutes, but it's still going on YouTube because it's a dandy. But anyways, this is Matthew Randazzo. This is 217 Top Trades. Good luck to the market and everybody in it. Goodbye.